Chatreel with Billy and Friends. And now, here is your host, Billy Tappin.
Welcome, welcome. How's everybody out there? We're worldwide. Chatreel with Billy and Friends. Tonight we are with Corey Mcleichy. And we'll be talking with him about some of the great history making things that he's involved in. And we welcome you, my cousin. We welcome you, Corey, to the show.
Yes.
How are you doing?
Hey, yeah. Thank you, my brother.
All right. Now, what we're going to do, Corey, is we're going to introduce you to everybody. We'll let everybody know that we have Corey Mcleichy, and he's an outstanding person. He's got a great history, and I should say we have a great history. So what I'm going to do first, Corey, before we even get into this, I'm going to introduce you to everybody that's on the air with me. We're going to talk with our friends, TJ. Welcome to the show.
Yeah,
Corey.
I'm here.
Okay, welcome to the show, with Corey Mcleichy.
Yep. Welcome, Corey.
Thank you.
All right. Next, we have Denise Bukatis.
Hi, Corey.
Hey,
yes, I'm
doing?
Here. Can you hear me? I'm good. It's welcome to the program, Corey.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
We're good. Do we have Robin in yet?
No, we did not.
Okay. Okay, she's not in yet. Julie Sepulveda, are you in?
No.
Okay, all right. All right, let's do this. Let's go to a quick commercial break, and we'll be right back. TJ, you want to send us there?
You're listening to CRS Radio, the Knowledge Station. The chat reel with Billy and Friends. This week's guest, historian Mr. Corey Mcleichy. Stay tuned. We'll be right back.
The Caribbean Radio Show with Evie and the chat reel with Billy and Friends proudly sponsors the Give Back to Jamaica project. We give shoes to families in need throughout the country. We encourage our listeners to partner with the Give Back Jamaica Inc. Drive. We believe in whatever it takes to build a nation. It will improve a nation by giving. Send your monthly donations in any amount. Every penny counts. Or send your shoe donation in. Don't forget to tell Evie at CRS Radio that the chat reel sent you. Send your donation to www.givebackjamaica.org or email Evie at jamaica@gmail.com. That is jamaica@gmail.com.
Thank you. my success is so deadly. It's wrong if I'm killed, but when I'm wrong, it's okay. The standards that we hold each other to, I never say. I thought music was a way out, but it pulls you in deeper. You're a target in the ghetto when they feel you're trying to leave them. Where was the support when nobody believed? I knew there was never any honor amongst these. Stay poor and they love you when we're huddled in the struggle. Make it out, then come back. Oh, you changed, now it's fuck you. Kill him for his change. Put a bullet in his brain. He left us here to starve. So one's gonna feel our pain. But he was just like us, born into poverty. He just had the will to chase his dreams and get up off the street. These are the results. After all the good he did, then you can have his life. I just wanna live. I wanna live and not die because I'm truthful. Being questioned about the gangster, it's not something that you're used to. Spreading lies about me, it's only right that I correct you. What's not understood can be explained. That's not disrespectful, but you won't need to die. We don't see eye to eye if I'm alive after that happens. I'm a threat to your pride. Forgive me if you took it wrong, but that's not what it is. We don't need to kill each other for it. I just wanna live and be a father to my kids. What we beefing over small, get it resolved when we big. I be ready to die, not until it's time. And that we'll never know until then. Keep in mind that I just wanna live and not die because I'm truthful. Being questioned about the things that it's not something that you're used to. Spreading lies about me, it's only right that I correct you. What's not understood can be explained. That's not disrespectful, but you want me to die because we don't see eye to eye if I'm alive after that happens. I'm a threat to your pride. Forgive me if you took it wrong. That's not what it is. We don't need to kill each other for it. I just want to live and be a father to my kids. But even though it's small, get it resolved, we'll be big. I ain't ready to die, not until it's time. And that we'll never know. Until then, keep in mind that I just want to live.
Introducing Caribbean Radio Show, the chat reel with Billy and friends. And now, here is your host, Billy Tappin.
And we are back. We are CRS Worldwide. And if you're just noticing or coming on, I should say, we have a special, special guest. And his name is Corey Mcleichy. And Corey has a story to tell us on some really, really deep stuff. We go back in history. We do it all over here at CRS Radio. Matter of fact, all the listeners out there, be sure to tell your friends, your mom, your dad, your kids. We are a very, very clean show. We talk about a lot of things. So right now, we're going to be going into the conversation with my boy, Corey Mcleichy. Corey, how you doing, man?
What's up? What's up, cousin?
Hey, another day in paradise, cuz.
You forgot to tell him that.
Oh, no doubt. Family here all day long. Hey, and it's nothing but love here. And I think a lot of people are going to be inspired by this young man. And like I said, I love him. I've been waiting for him to come on. We just had to wait for the calendar to get straight. But we are. So before we get into it, this great conversation, we'd like to welcome once again, my friends, before we get into the what we like to take. What we're going to do here, Corey, tell me a little bit about your background, and then we'll get into the stuff that you're doing. How did we get here? How did we get to this point in your life?
Well, first of all, you know, I got to acknowledge my cousin, the family historian, Thomas Mcleichy. May he rest in peace.
Amen.
When I was about 5 years old, I was in Battle Creek at a family reunion, and he would post these little placards on trees, have nailed them to trees, these plaques of, like, different newspaper clippings, pictures, and all that kind of stuff. And, I was too young at that time to really understand what he was doing or what it was all about. But then, as time progressed, like when I was in elementary, I had a couple school teachers that would acknowledge me during Black History Month. And, I didn't even really know, until they told me, because when I was five, I wasn't paying attention, trying to read nothing at the park. I was playing. But when I was in elementary, a teacher, made mention of it. And because, I'm the youngest of nine kids. So all of my siblings who came before me, they were aware of Sojourner Truth through my siblings. The school teachers were. So when I got there, they made me aware, because it wasn't something that everybody talked about at home at the dinner table or nothing like that. It was just something that was known in our family, but nobody really talked about it heavily like that. And my own father didn't even believe the stories that he heard about her when he was coming up, because something like that is too amazing to kind of fathom, that you related to this great iconic woman. And even when I was told that I was related to her, I didn't believe it either. I try to do some research on my own and look for some type of correlation with my last name and her name and all that, and I, really didn't see anything that convinced me, But
okay.
So through just learning through my teacher and a couple of teachers at elementary and some teachers in high school, Ottawa Hills High School, they were, Mr. Johnson, Mr. Cannon, they would say it. And, I was proud, but I still wasn't convinced. And it was only the time that I really wanted to let it, sink in and probably acknowledge it is when my family was invited to the Capitol during the Obama administration. And, he reached out to my brother Ben, and I was living in Atlanta at the time. My brother Ben called me and told me about it. So it was an unveiling of a Sojourner Truth bust in the Capitol. She's the first Black woman. She was the first Black woman to be unveiled in the Capitol. She's not anymore, but at that time in 2009, she was the first woman to have a bust in the Capitol created by Artist Lane, an African-American woman sculptor. And so we went to the unveiling. Like I said, was invited there by the Obama administration. Michelle Obama, Nancy Pelosi, Hillary Clinton, and Sheila Jackson Lee, they all unveiled the statue, and they gave us a standing ovation and everything. Michelle Obama, she made a speech, and so it was all kind of it was kind of sinking in on me. I was like, if Michelle Obama is going to acknowledge me as a descendant of Sojourner Truth, then I'm going to take that and run with it,
Oh, no,
especially
no,
she has some Secret Service agents come and get me and my youngest daughter, London, and they whisked us to the back of the Capitol or in the Capitol somewhere in a room because Michelle Obama wanted to take pictures with the descendants. And that's a picture that I've been trying to get, man, for the last so many years, but I've been unsuccessful at trying to retrieve that picture. But that's basically how we got here, you know, in a nutshell.
Okay. Well, you know what? In terms of the pictures, them will come quite naturally as the progress continues. I am just learning from you myself the connection now because of Malcolm X, and it was one of the presidents I was telling you about too. That's kind of, you know, where we're at with it. But, you know, I think it's a tremendous opportunity to be able to display something like this in this time of the day. I mean, as far as what we're involved into right now with the world, what's going on in the world, I think this is the time for it. It's been long overdue. So I know that you have a lot of things that you're doing. Let's talk about the documentary. Let's talk about that. So you're getting ready to put that out. So give us a little idea where you're at with that.
Well, as far as the documentary go, what we did, the documentary was something that just happened because of the COVID, because me and Latif Calloway, shout out to my brother Latif, East Side of Detroit native. He's a film director and producer on this project. Me and him met like 10 years ago and been like brothers ever since. We had a meeting with Amazon Studios out in California. And so we were trying to shop the idea of doing, you know, like 3 or 4 episodes to try and tell her story because, you know, we wanted to do a movie and we're still going to do a movie, a biopic about her. But you can't talk about her whole life in just 2 hours. So that's why we were trying to do like a couple episodes of her life with Amazon. And so they really liked the idea so much after we, you know, did our little spiel. They actually wanted us to do 2 seasons, like 2, I guess that's 10 episodes per season. So
yeah,
that was going down, you know, and then COVID happened and we had to reconfigure some things. And so, you know, Cal, he's pretty tenacious, man. He's a real intelligent guy and you know, he's just a go-getter. And the world was put on pause, but he was like, man, we got to do something, you know, Hollywood shut down or whatever. He said, we got to keep it going. So he came up with the idea of just shooting to New York. And he said, man, we're going to do a documentary instead because we can handle this ourselves, you know, get the footage and everything. So we basically, me and my cousin, Thomas Mcleichy, may rest in peace, drove all the way to New York. And we, you know, Cal, he had the idea, we're going to walk in the footsteps of Sojourner Truth. We're going to visit everywhere that she was enslaved. We're going to go to the courthouse where she won her son back out of slavery, as well as going to the lawyer office where she went and hired the lawyer. We went to the home where she was, first time she was able to sleep in a bed, you know, and it was pretty cool, too, because when we got to that particular property, she was, the people were sitting there. It was a groundskeeper. He was there. And, you know, just sitting there tending to the land. It was a beautiful property, man, probably about, I don't know, 20 acres or so. It was real vast. You could see the fields. And then it was just, like, enchanting because while I was looking at this big open space, I was imagining her working the field and all of that, you know, everything. So we checked it out, got some footage, and we was about to leave. And my cousin Thomas, he was like a little irritated. He's like, man, we didn't come all this way just to look at the trees and the grass. He's like, man, go up to the door, knock on the door, let them know we want to talk to somebody. We're here. And so the residents, but the groundskeeper, we introduced ourselves to him, told him who he was, and he said he would let the homeowners know that you know, we were there. And so when we left that property, I said about 30 minutes later, we got a call. The guy called us back. The family was real excited. They wanted to meet us. So we doubled back the next day, came to the property. You know, we ate lunch and all that and kicked it with them. And they were just giving us a little history on the property. They let us go down in the basement and showed us where the I guess you call it the keystone or whatever, from the old house. Mm-hmm. That was from, they showed us where the old house stopped and where the new addition was added on. So we got a little bit of history on that. And, you know, it was surreal, man. You know, ironically, the little boy who lived there was doing a book report on Sojourner Truth that week, you know, so he was able to get a little photo out with me. I signed his book report, you know, and he had a good something to talk about when he went back to school. And, you know, it was real, man. We had a good experience at that property. And
well, that is awesome. That's awesome, because I know as we spoke about the connection between us, I also talked to our person, or my aunt and my cousin, because they do all the family histories. So we're very much connected through the Joneses. So that was really deep, because like I told you, that me and Burl and Tom, you know, we came up together, you know.
Right.
And we played ball together. So, I mean, I know the family really well. The younger ones, not so much. But I remember, you know, their dad, I remember him, you know. So we had a very good relationship coming up as kids. And, you know, I thought at some point in time, I said, they might be some family. But, you know, I was young. We all was young. So we never really
You know, we always got fake cousins.
Yeah, yeah. So that's what it is. So it's a big, big family. And this project is going to be huge once it gets going and everything gets laid out. So now you're talking about the two series. Are they going to still work with that, or is plans changed on that?
What's going on is Latif, he just locked in a situation when I was in Washington, D.C. just recently, and I'm not privy to say how it's going to all go down or when. I mean, I can say next year it's definitely going to be released. I can't tell you on which platform, because we don't know yet. We're going to go with the most lucrative one, of course. But I sat down with Amazon, and our meeting was supposed to be like a half-hour meeting with Amazon, but we ended up talking for 2 hours. They was really excited about everything. They even told me that they would, promote my top-notch kids agenda at the end of each segment, you know, put my website up and all of that. And you know, they want us to do 20 episodes, which is two seasons. And that's going to be like a episodic mini-series about Sojourner Truth. And then we're going to do a biopic after that, which is the movie. But coming first is going to be the documentary. I just want to shout out my cousin, Sean Jones Durr, since you mentioned the whole Malcolm X connection. I got to jump on that real quick. And shout out to my cousin, drummer, Alphonse Brown, you know, and my cousin, his mother, Debbie Jones, you know, she went to South High School. You probably know her, too.
Oh, yeah.
But, yeah, so what happened was Sean Jones Durr, shout out to Danny Durr, too, Salaam Alaikum, you know, that's my Muslim brother out there, her husband. She went on Debbie Jones, her sister, site, you know, the DNA.
Oh, you're talking about, yeah, where you look at your genetics?
Yeah, yeah. So she went Ancestry.com.
Ancestry DNA.
So she, yes, but she was on there searching, just looking, you know, doing it, because she's like the family historian for the Jones and the Durs, you know, and she found Sojourner Truth on her side, on the Jones side, you know, and I was like, oh, man. So she broke it down to me, and what we discovered is that I am related to Malcolm X through marriage, because her father, Bobby Jones, this is my father's first cousin, my second cousin, he married Malcolm X's youngest sister, Yvonne Little.
Oh, my goodness.
So,
right, that is
awesome. Yeah, so they had kids. and their kids became my bloodline cousins, you know. So Malcolm X is just my cousin through marriage, but their kids are my real blood cousins. And Sojourner Truth is their, you know, great-great aunt through marriage, you know. So it's kind of deep.
Yeah, this is what the deal is, because the connection also is with Malcolm and us, and then we go into the Benjamin Banneker situation, and we're in that aspect of it also. Benjamin Banneker, I know you're familiar with him, right?
Oh, yeah. Oh, man, I'm definitely familiar with him because, as I told you before, a guy by the name of Ty L. Gray, shout out to Ty L. Gray, he's a spoken word artist, and he had, like, 12 standing ovations out in Berkeley, California for his speech on he got a bunch of powerful speeches that he uplifted about black women, this and that. And so I was speaking to him. Before I put out my children's book, before I wrote and illustrated my children's book, he wanted to hire me to illustrate his children's book that he was doing about Benjamin Banneker. And, you know, when I learned about Benjamin Banneker, I was blown away because, you know, he laid out the whole foundation for Washington, D.C., you know, the whole landscape, the streets, the buildings,
right.
You know. And, I mean, and it's like just with this thing that's going on right now in the media with the black girl, you know, throwing up her little sign versus the white girl doing it first. Well, Benjamin Banneker discovered relativity before Einstein did. But Einstein got the credit, you know what I mean? So
exactly.
One of those things,
well,
man. Go ahead.
Well, let me say this. On Banneker, how he ended up getting it was through his neighbor at that time. Him and Molly at that time were together, I believe, Molly Walsh. And the neighbors, the one that was good friends with the president, I can't remember which president it was. Anyway, they took him to the site to actually develop Washington, D.C., to lay that out. And it was a white guy that was supposed to be ahead of that. And he said he wasn't going to work with no end person. You
right.
Know? And so he left the job, and that's where Banneker took over. So it's deep history. So I actually have a story I wrote, me and a cousin wrote on. I've got that. So
yeah, man, that's just wild that you said that, because I have illustrations of Benjamin Banneker. When I started to do the illustrations for Ty L. Gray's book, and then, you know, we ran into a little snag, so we held off on that, and I already had in mind that I was going to do a children's book about the Journey of Truth, so that's when I just took it upon myself to start working on my children's book. You know,
right. Now, let's do this. Let's take a quick commercial break, and we're going to go back to the situation on Banneker, and we're going to talk about Harriet Tubman some more. So let's take a quick commercial break, and we'll be right back. TJ?
You're listening to CRS Radio, the Knowledge Station. This week's guest, Corey Mcleichy, a direct descendant of Sojourner Truth. We'll be back at you with more info and Corey right after this.
Shalom and hello. This is Dr. Denise Sotadis. I am a metaphysician and a licensed psychotherapist and a natural medicine doctor. I am also the host of the Black Jewish Queen live chat and also one of the hosts of the chat reel with Billy and Friends. If you are enjoying these programs, please support our cause to keep our programs on the air so that we can continue covering topics that matter to you. You can send your donations in any amount to paypal.me/psychotherapy-CHECKOU. That is paypal.me/psychotherapy-CHECKOU. We look forward to your support. Thank you so much for listening to our program.
Thank you. I'm a bigger man. I took risks, penitentiary chance, all that I happen to still exist. God meant me to have a fight in the big league. For the cause, these final brawls are chance. In history, I'm a bigger man. I took risks, penitentiary chance, all that I happen to still exist. God meant me to have a fight in the big league. For the cause, these final brawls are chance. In history, child. He is the name, royalty in the flesh. A heart of stone beat to my chest. Streets I finesse, I receive my respect, yes, without squeezing the tech. But please don't jump wrong, you may lead to your death. All you silly yous and little me's, I have Jewish knees and ever mind for war, the law to run the shores of Greece with my African pride. Those who plan my demise begin gnashing their teeth. Damn, the man is alive. I wear death and wrath as my game face. Every blood link to that is the connection my chain makes. I smell a reaper stench, but his face is a blur. I'm reeking of weed smoke, frankincense, and the myrrh. So to the powers that be, from my brow to my feet, I'll never bow to the beast, pass my crown of defeat. I'll expose the gowns on you each, till you drown in belief. To the ground you're beneath, you always hear the shout it from me. I'm a bigger man, I took risks, penitentiary chance. All that I happen to still exist. God meant me to have a fight in the big league. For it all, these final brawls are chance. In history, I'm a bigger man. I took risks, penitentiary chance. All that I happen to still exist. God meant me to have a fight in the big league. For it all, these final brawls are chance. In history, if I offended my enemies, you know where I stand now. Talk of the city, every alley, corner, and campground. Between the shade and the pot, on your way to the block. Balling and beauty shop, speak my name is some lot. I'm the king and yeah, he's the prince. It's Todd that said it, by the album you can read it in print. Wealthy I bleed it, talk I secreted. The glutton, the grime, legions, the liars I fight is doing the course of my breathing. Niggas, I'm the source, a different force of nature. My chick says her life is like the memoirs of a geisha. This is a madman's diary. Black boy oppressed, Dutch after Dutch, to the skies, my S.O.S. Love me or leave me alone. I've got multiple ferocious words eat through the bone. Hate me but respect me. I have a seat on the throne. Don't waste your time hurting your own. Be at ease with stone. I'm a bigger man. I took risks, penitentiary chance. From all that, I happen to still exist. God meant me to have a fight in the big league. For it all, these final brawls are chance. In history, I'm a bigger man. I took risks, penitentiary chance. From all that, I happen to still exist. Meant me to have a fight in the big league. For it all, these model brawls are chance in history. I'm still passionate, more advanced than the average. I'm hip-hop's Lazarus, blow out the candles lit. Wealthy street alive, we came out of those bandages. Healed the wounds, strengthened the legs, now we can stand again. I seen the smiles that are downfalls, detects and town calls. Y'all saying it's over, what are we around for? Redemption song, dog, I don't stand alone. I'm the voice to put us back where the fam belongs. I'm a bigger man, I took risks, penitentiary chance. To all that, I happen to still exist. God meant me to have a fight in the big league. For it all, these model brawls are chance. In history, I'm a bigger man. I took risks, penitentiary chance. To all that, I happen to still exist. God meant me to have a fight in the big league. For it all, these model brawls are chance. In history, yeah.
Hear me?
Yes, sir.
You hear me, Corey?
Yes, sir.
Introduce.
Okay. Okay. All right, we're back. Corey, let's go back to the Banneker situation. Like I said, I have a script that I put together on that. But let's talk a little bit about that. I know you're doing the children's book, but what I want to do before we get into that conversation, let us know how people can get in contact with you if they want to order the book, and we'll talk about the book as well because we're going to talk about everything while we're on here. So how can they find you?
Oh, well, they can reach me at www.descendantsofthetruth.com, and you can subscribe there for you know, all the latest updates and things we got going on. You could also use that platform to contact me personally, because I'm the one that created the website and I host the website and all of that stuff. So you won't be like talking to a robot or no AI or nothing like that. I'm real hands on. And, you know, all my social media sites, I got Instagram, the DOT 20, DOT AD 2020, I believe. That's Instagram. And what else? So I have Facebook. On Facebook, I'm Nakamichi Mcleichy. That's Nokamichi. And usually when you put in the first name, it automatically pops up because there's not a lot of people got that nickname. That just so happens to be a nickname. A lot of my close friends called my, even people in high school, they were like, who is that? What is that all about? But that's just, there's something to that name. And it's also my my artist pen name, you know, so I do artwork. A lot of people don't know about that as of yet, but that's coming up this year. I'm going to be releasing some real exclusive artwork that I've been working on in conjunction with the Universal Hip Hop Museum. I had a conversation with Rocky Buchano in 2018, somewhere around there. And what I'm doing is I'm creating these 3 feet by 5 feet canvas paintings of different African American people, not of just history, but people who are philanthropists and who have done great things for their community. And all the canvases are black. I painted all the canvases black because the name of the series is called Invincible Black. And I painted them black because you can't buy those size canvases. But as a matter of fact, it's very hard to find any black canvases in the store. So the theme of it is Invincible Black, all black canvases about all black iconic figures in our community that's doing something for the community, you know. And so I'm going to have all of my paintings hopefully on display at the Universal Hip Hop Museum and the Bronx in New York off the Hudson River. It's a $350 million museum that's already constructed, and they have probably 80% done, and it'll open their doors in 2024. So
okay.
I got that going.
Okay. Yes, if you're listening, we're back with Corey Mcleichy. He is a descendant of
Sojourner
of I lost my thought real quick. Sorry about that.
No,
but anyway,
you said Harriet Tubman the last time. I was going to correct you, but the reason why you said Harriet Tubman, because I got some affiliation with her too, so we could, not that I'm a descendant, but, you know, we could talk about that as well, because that's where I think you got mixed up, because I have been promoting her heavily too, because just about 2 weeks ago, 2.5 weeks ago, I was invited up to New York for the unveiling of the Harriet Tubman statue created by Vinnie Bagwell. She's a black woman, a sculptor. She's world renowned. She's a very, very good friend of mine. She's my mentor, you know, and she's super dope, man. She's bad, man. I mean, she'd be pumping out statues like, man, 40 going north, and she incredible. So she had recently told me a while ago when she did a party for me, because she created the statue of Sojourner Truth. It was unveiled in 2020 in the height of the pandemic. And so that particular day that her statue was unveiled in New York, there was another statue simultaneously being unveiled in New York, Sojourner Truth, at the same time. So, you know, Sojourner Truth is the only black woman, the first black woman to have two statues of her unveiled on the same day at the same time. So I can only make it to one of them because the one statue is being unveiled in New York Central Park by this white woman named Meredith, I forget her last name. But there was some controversy with that. Well, I'll talk about that in a minute. But I was going to support Vinnie Bagwell because I flew up to get to North, and we became friends. So he threw a party for me, and that's how I kind of met. Like I said, I was introduced to Ty Gray Ale, who wanted me to do the illustrations for the Benjamin Banneker book, and then that's how I met my girl Jennifer McZeer. Jennifer McZeer is an art enthusiast. She's a very brilliant black young woman, and she is just an overall great person. And we were friends for about a year or so after the fact, but I never knew that she was on the board for the hip-hop, the Universal Hip-Hop Museum. I didn't know. She's like this real, like, intelligent museum buff, you know, like art museums or whatever. Kind of. She knows she's very knowledgeable. So talking small talk with her, and that's how I was able to get introduced to Rocky Buchano, the owner of the Universal Hip Hop Museum, which is a $350 million museum off the Hudson River in the Bronx. And, you know, everything, I mean, it's all tied in. But with the whole Harriet Tubman thing, that's how I met. That's why you were talking about Harriet Tubman, because when offline, you know, when me and you talking, I've been sharing all my experiences with you and just our personal conversations. So that's why, you know, she had the party. She had a party for me, so she said Harriet Tubman's niece had seen her Facebook post, and she's like, I want a party, you know. So Vinny said, oh, yeah. You know, she was excited that Harriet Tubman's niece even reached out to her, because she said she knows that there's other descendants out here of these great iconic people, but they're hiding. They're in hiding, you know, because there's, you know, the deep story about what happened with the Littles and how the government treated the Shabazz family, man. You know, it was wicked, you know.
No doubt.
But for me, I'm saying I'm fearless, man, and I ain't no shit talking nothing like that. Excuse the language, but ain't nobody gonna alter what I feel I want to say to my community or to the world, or they ain't gonna make me go run in the corner and hide. You know, just like Malcolm, man. That's why he's my hero, and I love Malcolm X with all my heart, because see, he sacrificed himself basically for the betterment of mankind, because he knew it was a possibility that he was going to get assassinated, and he still went to that podium and spoke his mind, man. So that's who I look up to. That's who I admire. And like I told, even when they had that party for me in New York, it was, man, lawyers and mayors, dignitaries from all walks of life, and they were interviewing me, news. Channel 12 News in New York interviewed me openly, and you know, I said, yeah, I'm a grandson of Sojourner Truth, and I love that, the fact that I am, but I kind of can relate to Harriet Tubman just a little bit more, you know what I'm saying? And that's just what it is. That's just what it is, man, because what these white people got to understand, because all of them ain't bad, you know, all white people ain't bad, just like all black people ain't bad, but the racists got to understand that they need to understand. Man, they ain't scaring nothing, man. They ain't scaring nothing at all. And they better be careful themselves, because you know what? It's over for all that kumbaya stuff. You know what I'm saying? All we got to do is just get our you know, people in line a little bit better. We need to tighten it up, you know, and they be feeding us these lies, talking about black fathers are absent from the home, this, that, and the other. I just read up on it even, and some real valuable research that shows that the black father is in his children's lives more often than all the other ethnicities, without a doubt, whether it's white, Latino, or whatever. We are in our kids' lives. They putting out these false perceptions of who we are, just to beat us down even more. You know, so I had a guy ask me. Go ahead, sir.
Well, that's what they do. That's what they do. And it's the elites that do this. And like I said, Malcolm, I'm like you, man. I ain't bowing down for nobody. You know what I'm saying? My truth is my truth. And I think that if Malcolm was still here today, we'd have a much different world in terms of black people and people of color.
Right.
You know, I truly believe that. And they didn't want that. They did not want it. So we can go on and on about this, but I'm telling you, I've seen it from a kid all the way up. When they first started with segregation and stuff like that, I've seen the game, you know, because we had our cousin actually was against it. because she had a vision of what this was going to be. We were the fastest growing people of color, especially blacks, were the fastest growing people back there in the 50s and 60s. So they had to put a stop to that. That's why they came up with all this, you know, we can work together and go to school together. That's what that was all about, as a setup. So they could take all the stuff that we earned and made and buy us out.
Exactly.
And that's,
I mean, that's
bad.
That's why they don't want, they talking about this whole woke thing and the woke this. The reason why it's bothering them is because all the real truth is coming out. The truth's coming out. Man, you got Asian people talking real candidly and fluently about how white America has persecuted the black man in his own backyard and this and that. And they said, you did all this. You gave away all the land to all the people except us. You know what I'm saying? You stole the land. You know, in Africa, I seen it on the news where back in the day, they stole, man, they already took the land from a lot of the countrymen over there. And then when there was an uprising, and I think it was in Zimbabwe or somewhere like that, where the Africans came back and reclaimed their land. Do you know the United States put sanctions on that country over there? You know what I'm saying? They said, we ain't going to do no import-export with this country because the black people are coming back to get their land back, their own property. You know what I'm saying? America twisted,
man. Let's
look at
this.
They twisted.
Let's look at this. And what they did, they've been doing all throughout centuries of controlling and putting fake wars together. You know what I mean? This is just, they're working hand in hand, man. Just everything to be destructive. And now we're losing the value of the dollar. I mean, everybody's changing their currency up. You know, this world is a disaster, but they don't care because they got bunkers underneath the ground that they think they're going to escape. But, you know, you can't escape God. So they can have whatever they want down there, but when it starts happening, they're going to be destroyed as well. So
you're right. They can't escape God in the way I feel.
Hey, yeah,
I'm not a martyr. I ain't trying to be a martyr or nothing like that. But I feel like there's no way they can stop me because what I've already created is out here. The statements I've made are already being recorded. The posts I put on Facebook are already, you know, in place. So it's like if anything happened to me, all it's going to do is perpetuate my message and my movement that I left behind. So I'm good.
There you go. There you go. And this is my whole situation. And I say this all the time. You know, I'm all about truth. I'm all about justice. And I'm all about people. And I'm saying people have to wake up of all colors because they ran a game on everybody. They lied to everybody in this country and around the world. So it's something that we have not woken up to. It's the fact of who's actually controlling this. Who's puppeteering all this stuff? It's not our government. We're in here talking about the government. It's not them. They're taking kickbacks from the ones that's controlling, the puppeteers. So once you correct the puppeteers and get them straightened out, that's when you have a free country. That's when people live in harmony without going through all these things.
No, the thing if it is, I can't even say that it is government collectively because, you know, there's good people in government positions, you know what I'm saying? So it's all of this stuff, man, it's just like it was wild because if you got an evil person in a powerful position, they're going to do evil things. If you got a good person in that position, they're going to do good things, you know, within the government or outside of the government. So the government ain't necessarily the bad entity. It's the people who running it. You know, all of the people, you know.
Let me interject this, Corey. It's all about the power to be, the ones that are behind this, and also the ones that have been in there for 50, 60 years, they're the most corrupt that you can have. Get them all out and get one term. One term, you do your job and get out. And cut government down. You know, you're sitting there stealing the people's money, and also the elites, they're stealing, you know.
Right.
The military, they don't even know. Yeah, a lot of people don't know. Yeah, they talking about the president. The president ain't got nothing to do with it. It's the elite that controls all this.
Right.
So I'm just telling people got to wake up, man. The 1%. You know what I'm saying? They sitting back laughing at us because they're the ones that brainwashed everybody into this nonsense. But let's do
exactly.
this. Let's take a quick commercial break, and we'll be right back with Corey Mcleichy. All right, TJ? Okay.
Hello.
Corey.
And shalom, chat realers. This is Dr. Denise Bacardis, metaphysician, philosopher, and psychotherapist. I am one of the hosts of the chat room with Billy and Friends. I'm also the host of the Black Jewish Queen live chat. I am here to announce another good friend of Billy Tappan and Friends, the writer of The Matrix and Terminator, the original Oracle herself, sci-fi writer, Oscar and award-winning Sophia Stewart. Did you know that Sophia Stewart has a lineup of fantastic books available, especially for those who loved and enjoyed her written work of The Matrix and The Terminator movies? If you love these movies, you will love her books. Her latest book is quite exciting for those who love The Matrix. It is called The Evolution of Conscious, Matrix 4. That is The Evolution of Conscious, Matrix 4. In this book, Sophia Stewart talks about cracking the genetic code. This is a must read for those who love The Matrix and The Terminator. I am happy to announce this book is available on Amazon, Barnes & Noble bookstores. It is also a recommended book on Goodreads, along with her other best-selling five-star books. Number one, The Third Eye. Number two, The Mother of the Matrix. Number three, Matrix Trivia, all written by Sophia Stewart. These books are popular, and they are selling fast. Order your copy today. Don't forget, Sophia Stewart's books are available on Amazon, sold at your local Barnes & Noble bookstores. You can even purchase her books on Goodreads. You can also visit her webpage at thetruthaboutmatrix.com. That is thetruthaboutmatrix.com. Order yours before supply runs out. The choice is yours. The blue pill or the red pill. Chat with you soon, your people. Bye-bye.
Involves a fee. Never let your want for success outweigh your needs. Don't ever share your plans. They'll hate what you've achieved. Jealousy is sick. Some say a disease. Even when they don't, you gotta believe. Just believe.
Thank you. Problems, but we're on point, so we're going to keep it rolling. I've got Corey Mcleichy, in case you're just now tuning in. It's been an amazing conversation, amazing story, but we're going to have we're listening to some of Tahisa's Martin's music, and let's talk about that just for a bit, then we're going to get to your book, Corey. So,
hey, man, you're a genius, man. You're a mind reader. You're a mind reader. Hey, I'm going to tell you for real, man, it's all divine intervention, man, because, you know, let's just talk about how good of a person you are, man, and how great Billy and friends are, your friends TJ and your homegirl, I forgot her name, sorry, but, you know, y'all doing a great service to people like me and artists and speakers, and I just want to take the time out to thank y'all and acknowledge this amazing platform because it's necessary, man. I know you got like 3.9 million listeners tapped in right now. And, you know, we got to acknowledge y'all for doing the hard work and creating a platform so we can reach the world. But, like, getting back on with Ty, man, what I was going to say, we were saying you was a genius because during the break I was saying, man, listen to that, man. I said, this is dope. I said, I got to interrupt Billy. I know he want to go to the children's book, but I got to interrupt him just to point out to the masses, look at how it's the lineup. First, you hear all the positive music in the rap. If you replay this segment, this show, listen to it again, that lineup, it's on purpose. We're doing it on purpose. It's a movement. We're trying to reach our peers, our family, your friends, strangers, trying to bring their attention to the light, you know, and what we're saying. Just like with the whole thing, the last song you just heard, The Disconnect, basically what we're saying in that those lyrics is, you know, like, white people, how dare you? You know what I'm saying? We taught y'all what y'all know now. The Moors came, you know, across the world and showed people how to live the right way, how to grow shit, how to, you know, live and independently. And, you know, we love everybody. African people love everybody. Go to Africa right now, man, in any country, they're going to embrace you. They're going to feed you. They're going to show you their landscape. You know what I'm saying? They ain't trying to murder you and deceive you and get over on you. You know what I'm saying? We're good-natured people by birth. But when you back us up against the wall and you continue to ridicule us, you continue to disrespect us and neglect us and take from us and chase us down in the street like dogs and try to kill us, what you think we about to do? You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? You purposely trying to ignite, you know, that situation where it's a race war and people have been avoiding that for decades, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Because they got systems placed up against it. They got, you know, and so, I mean, it's crazy, man. And a lot of us are sick and tired of this shit, man. You know, we tired of it. We ain't did nothing.
Right.
None of them, man. You know what I'm saying? We ain't, everybody in the world got compensation for something. You know, they damn near annihilated the Indians, but then gave them these casinos. But if you ask me, money don't buy love. You can't bring back all those murdered loved ones with billions of dollars. That don't mean shit. You know what I'm saying? But
it doesn't.
We don't got nothing. You know what I'm saying? They didn't give us nothing. We don't need nothing from them. What we need y'all to do is quit effing with us. Let us be.
Right.
Let us rebuild. Let us repopulate and leave us alone, man, because you're continuing to just press these buttons, man, and like you just wanted to jump off so y'all could have a reason to, you know, go all in. You know what I mean? So it's only so much we could talk about. You know, it ain't, you know, like we are some type of militia against the government or the white people in general, but we tired of this shit, man. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah.
I'm here paying.
Yeah.
You know, it's just crazy. So, but like I just say, I wanted to acknowledge that because, you know, you hear the positivity in the music and then the movement I got, it's all positive. It embraces all races and cultures because, like, I had to correct people on some things. You know, man, we all got all different type of nationalities mixed up in this. Sojourner Truth, Sojourner Truth got Latin descendants in Cali, Asian descendants, African. My cousins of Battle Creek, white as snow, you know what I'm saying? And I love them because they're my blood.
Yeah.
That's what was created. This is God. God ordained all of this. We are God's children. People got to get off their high horse and quit trying to just pick one group to be with, one side and one this, that. It's one race, and we know that.
Well, if
the people we call ourselves.
The other side.
You said
yeah.
What?
When you meet the other side of the family, you're going to see the same thing and see multicolored colors. From Hispanics, Arabic, blacks, some of them look white. So yes,
right.
it's a blend of everything. So this is my thing I'm trying to get people to do is raise your vibration up with love. And I don't care what color you are, raise the vibration
right.
up and you cannot be touched. You know,
right.
stop listening to these elites that are controlling your government. Stop listening to that nonsense. You have a choice. You could go ahead and raise your vibration and get your government straight. It actually needs to be restructured as far as I'm concerned. But that's another subject. But let's go
right.
to the book. Let's go to the kid's book, and let's talk about that.
Well, yeah. As far as the children's book goes, it's conveniently titled Keeping the Truth Alive. You know, and it's a very intimate tribute to my great descendant, great-great-grandmother, Sojourner Truth. I am her fifth-generation grandson. Her youngest daughter, who she walked to her freedom with, I call her Sophie, you know. She, who she walked to her freedom with, I am the youngest, or she is the youngest of Sojourner Truth's kids, and that is the lineage that I am connected to Sojourner Truth through. It's her youngest daughter, Sophia, who she walked through her freedom with.
Beautiful.
And in some of these history books, they say she ran, which is disrespectful because she walked, you know, feeling it was her God-given right to do so. So in my children's book, I touched on these little because it's when I say little, it's you can't tell about her whole life in just one little children's book. So I touch on some highlights in her life. It's a timeline, like from her birth to her death date. Her birth wasn't known because back then they didn't keep birth records on slaves. I don't even think on the greater part of the population for that matter, but definitely not on slaves. So we don't know her birth date, so we sort of celebrate her death date as her birthday, so to speak. So I did it's a nursery rhyme style timeline of her life from 1797 to 1883 when she died. And
Each page is a specific year where something took place. And so there's like 18 pages with that type of information and what particular year it took place. Like, for example, winning her son out of slavery. I talk about that. I talk about how she walked to her freedom. I talk about how she met Abraham Lincoln and asked for 40 acres and a mule. She's actually the one that coined that phrase, and that's where people get it from. She, you know, was invited to the White House by Abraham Lincoln, and she asked for 40 acres and a mule out west for black people, and that was around the time that they were giving away the land after the Civil War. And black people, of course, didn't get nothing, you know, so.
Right.
You know,
so where can they get the book from and how much?
Well, I would say this, if your listeners could wait a little bit, just because I don't want, I want them to get the discount, because what I had to do was issue my book. I'm revising it. I added like 2 pages to acknowledge some women doing some great work down in Akron, Ohio. They have a Sojourner Truth statue and a Sojourner Truth plaza being constructed. The statue is being created by Woodrow Nash, the world-renowned sculptor as well, a black man, world-renowned, and he's better known for his works of art and Beyonce's Disney special video, Black is King. He did a lot of that African sculptures in that video and did stuff for Jay-Z and Drake. And so he's from Akron, Ohio, and he was commissioned to do the statue of Sojourner Truth in Akron, Ohio. So this Sojourner Truth committee down there, when I sought them out and I went to the groundbreaking ceremony last year, and I met a lot of people, so we talked, and they actually teach about this. These women, during the whole CRT scandal, these women campaigned and, you know, picketed and all that to have black history taught in the public schools. You know, they were going against the grain, and not just black history, but specifically the story of Sojourner Truth, because of the reason why they are putting a statue in the plaza up of her in the first place is because there was an act in Ohio where she gave her famous speech, and I won, you know, and the place where they're putting the statue in the plaza is on the same grounds where she stood on the steps of the church and stood up when they told her they didn't want her to, but she stood up anyway after getting, you know, permission from the woman who was running the convention, gave her yielded her 5 minutes, whatever. She stood on the church steps right there at that very site and gave her famous speech. And so as it stands right now, Sojourner Truth is being taught in elementary school from I believe kindergarten to third grade, and then from in the seventh and eighth grade as well in Akron, Ohio, in this specific county. So
beautiful.
They're pushing to get my book and make my children's book part of their curriculum. So what I did was paid a couple thousand dollars to revise my children's book to acknowledge them pages. And then I'm reissuing it, and it's due to come out in about, I say, a month and a half from now. But if people don't want to wait, they just want to support me, which it ain't going to really be really supporting me, because that's a whole another story. But my book is out everywhere right now, all digital platforms and bookstores, Barnes and Nobles, and all everywhere. But the thing about it is it's selling for $23 right now. When I reissue my book, I'm only going to be selling it for $15 and extending that discount to everybody in the world, because the company I went with, Author House, they got me, because, you know, they did your boy in, man. They ran some game on, because if you look right now, you can see. I don't know how they did it, but it's a breach of contract or something going on. I mean, but I got some legal people on it. But the reason I say that is because I haven't been paid any royalties yet. And my book is right now on Amazon Books. My book is ranking like at 6,075,
675,000 and some odd numbers where it ranked out of 5 million books being sold on that platform, which means I'm in the top 10 percentile, but I haven't received a royalty check in over a year.
They so, over there in the Bahamas somewhere now.
You know, I'm really here. They somewhere, but it's cool because you know what? I'm all humble about it because either way it go, my plan is working because I'm just getting the message out there. I'm getting the word out there. The money going to come, you know.
Yes, it definitely
the
will.
The money going to come.
And let's do this. Let's do this. Are the lines, anybody out there wants to talk with Corey Mcleichy? They're more than welcome. The lines are open for anybody that wants to come on and speak that's not scared. You know what I'm saying? So come on with it. If not, we're going to keep on talking until we go to another place. Okay?
Yes, and the number is 661-467-2407 for anyone who wants to speak to Corey.
And press 1, and you'll come
yes.
on in. Meanwhile, we're going back to the conversation. So sometimes they get a little shy, but like I said, you know, we're all over. We are all over, and this is what our mission is I say it one step at a time for change, for all. Enough of the nonsense. We don't have time for that. We have to build. We can't expect any handouts. We got to come together as a whole. And I'm talking about blacks, whites, Hispanics. We all in this together, man. It's us against the world.
That's
you know
right.
what I'm saying? Us against the 1%. You know?
That's funny
we
you say we
got to
build because that's my motto with my whole Top Notch Kids program, which is affiliated with the Descendants of the Truth Foundation. My motto is we don't kill with guns, we build with guns. And
there you go.
You know, I got,
and you know,
and it's four,
you know,
it's four arms. It's four arms in the air, two girls, two boys, and they represent ethnicities because of the skin tone. It's different skin tones. And
that's right.
One is holding up a nail gun, one is holding up a heat gun, a caulk gun, and a paint gun. And like I said, we don't kill with guns, we build with guns, and that's the movement.
That's hot. And you know, worldwide as we are, I hope everybody can listen to this and hear this and support us any way you can, because we are here for change and difference. We want to make a change in this world. We want to make an impact. We want to help the homeless. We want to do a lot of things. We're going to be doing concerts coming up. Corey's helping out on a lot of situations that we got going on. And I'm very, very happy to have him on board and a family member. You know what I'm saying? All these years not knowing, and now we know. So I just love this topic because it really inspires me to even try harder. So,
right.
Corey,
well, yeah,
man.
We got to
think
that.
What I'm doing. With that. Yes. TJ, you want to ask Corey something?
Yeah. Corey, a couple of questions. With Sojourner Truth, if I'm not mistaken, wasn't she the first black person to be on a U.S. postage stamp?
I'm not sure. I'm not sure about that one, but I do know that I receive one of those stamps. I have one. They don't even make them anymore. Of course, you can't even order it. But I know it was a
right.
big deal. It was a big
yeah.
deal.
And also, the Benjamin Banneker. The whole question. I have a little tidbit on him. He's one of your relatives. You know, they had when the white guy said he didn't want to work with the N person. You know, he took his plans and left. Benjamin Banneker lay down on his back and took a sextant and looked up at the stars, and he laid out the foundation for Washington, D.C. in his head, on his back, at night, in the ground by looking at the stars. Ain't that something?
Incredible.
A great man he was. Yeah.
Hey, cuz, I didn't even know that, cuz. I just, you know, I'm glad you chimed in on that one. But I know
yeah.
you're
yeah.
incredible.
Yeah. And then you know what?
They claim they lost the plans, the blueprints, with D.C., but no, that guy took them, and Benjamin Banneker had to do them from memory by marking the stars in the sky with a sextant. He laid down on his back and did that. And that shows you how great a man he was, what a great inventor he was. He was a clockmaker, too. He made watches. Oh, yeah. Benjamin Banneker is the man.
Yeah. Yeah.
And you know what?
You know.
Yeah, he made a wooden clock. He made a replica of a watch out of wood.
Yep.
That operated for like 10 years or 20 years straight, I believe, or even maybe even longer.
And
but,
it kept accurate time to the minute. Yep.
Well, what I was going to say to that,
also,
like you said. So go ahead.
Okay, one last question for us, with your descendant, Sojourner Truth. I would like to know, since you've been down there, what was the pathway of the Underground Railroad that she came up to be in Battle Creek?
No, see, that's a big misconception on her, too, is because the woman who put out the Ain't I a Woman speech, which is really that historians say that she never even uttered those words, but that speech was written in the IR, it was presented to the masses like 12, 13 years after the fact, you know.
Okay.
And,
all right.
You know, so, and plus she never spoke, you know, a Southern accent. She never had a Southern accent. So that's,
right.
You know, that was a lie, you know. New York. She was from Ulster County, New York, and they tried to hide the fact that slavery even existed in New York, but New York happens to have one of the largest slave trades in the country, you know.
Thank you. And thank you. Say it again, brother. Say it again.
She spoke low Dutch and broken English, so she had more of a Dutch accent when she spoke. And another thing is people make a mistake with it. Sojourner Truth was never part of the Underground Railroad either. You know,
oh wow,
they think she was,
right.
But she all was.
Right. Okay, all right.
Yeah. She they
yeah,
she
see,
just
that's
get
what
associated
kids
with
in elementary
that.
School. Yeah, that's what they're teaching kids in elementary school. Because
yeah,
I grew up right here in
Lansing
and went to school. Yeah,
yeah, they think
yeah,
everything
was a lie.
Thank you, Corey.
Yeah, you know,
say it again, brother.
Yeah, man, people yeah. really don't know they because a lot of us just like you go to church and listen to the preacher preach instead of open the Bible throughout the week.
Read it for
you, learn for ourselves. Church and just listen instead of or the imam. They don't have to at the mosque instead of studying the Quran. You just listen to what the imam say because you being lazy. So with my descendants,
yeah.
I had to really dig deep and get into it to learn about all of these false statements and all these. Preconceptions about it. Even if you go to Wikipedia, you'll find out some lies about her in Wikipedia because they just whoever researched it and did it was lazy about it, you know. And Nell Irving Painter, a black woman, she's a historian. She's really the only one that gets highly credited for being the most accurate about Sojourner Truth's life, you know, in her history, and even. I won't even discredit her and say that, but what her research, because I read somewhere where she wrote that there are no known descendants of Sojourner Truth, and this was like in the '90s. But here
Wait
I am,
a minute.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
My cousins are so. This is what I said. If you could research something all the way back to the 1700s, 1800s, then surely you could find. Somebody that's connected from the 1900s or the 2000s, you know what I'm saying? That's like, that's not
exactly.
high, but you know,
right.
but
exactly.
I'm a real right. deep thinker in that way, so I don't try to discredit nobody, but I question everything, so I say she gets the most credit, but nobody's perfect,
mm-hmm.
you know what I'm saying?
Right.
A lot of people made
yeah.
mistakes on Sojourner Truth and this and that and the other. That's why I'm here to keep
well,
the truth
one
alive.
One last question, Corey. One last question. How did she come to be in Battle Creek?
Well, that's where she migrated to in her old age because, you know, she
from
was just
New York.
Yeah, she was going to settle there. I asked that question too recently, and either by stagecoach, because I think the railroads was just being built around those times, but it wasn't reaching Battle Creek, I don't believe, but possibly by stagecoach.
Coach, all right. Okay.
Okay.
Cool. Thank you, my brother.
Denise, you got anything you want to ask? Any questions?
Well, I wanted to know, you are related to Harriet Tubman as well, right?
No, I just met Harriet Tubman's niece in New York. Because I didn't get to, I'm glad you asked the question because I didn't get to finish. Because there's so much stuff to talk about, you know, it's crazy, you know. But When I was invited up in New York by Vinnie Bagwell, she threw a party for Harriet Tubman's niece because Vinnie Bagwell created this amazing statue of the young Harriet Tubman. And so she invited me up for any time she sends the statue to the foundry, she has a little party, whatever. So it was in clay form, and when she sent it to the foundry, it's going to get bronze. And so she has a little soiree, you know, with a couple of close friends and family. And she invited me up. I met Harriet Tubman's niece, you know, and it was real cool, you know. It was pretty amazing, you know. And I gave her a signed copy of my children's book. We took pictures. And what was so ironic, I mean, like I say, it's like, you know, the people say the ancestors are speaking. They have a certain way of letting us know that they're in our presence, you know, and it's all a divine thing from God as well, you know. Harriet Tubman's niece, and then I met this white woman. Her name is Barbara. What's her name? Barbara. I get flat. Her last name escapes me, but she was actually a creator for the Women on 20s campaign. You heard about that? The Women on 20s campaign?
No. Billy, have you heard of that one?
Yeah. Yep.
See, so
The Women on 20s campaign is a movement where they were going around and they had a contest. It was a nationwide contest where they were asking people to vote to see which woman that you wanted to have on the $20 bill. And Harriet Tubman won the nationwide contest. So what was so strange about that whole experience is I met Harriet Tubman's niece, and then I met the woman who started the Women of the 20s campaigns, who's Tubman is supposed to be put on the $20 bill. And the crazy part about that, what was so strange about that is 2 weeks later, I go to Washington, D.C., and I met a woman that had the same last name as the lady. Name was Barbara Howard. She started the Women on 20s campaign, Barbara Howard. And I met Harriet Tubman's niece, her, at Vinnie Bagwell's studio in New York. 2 weeks later, I go to Washington, D.C. I met a black woman named Cheryl Howard, who bought my children's book with three $20 bills that had Harriet Tubman's face stamped on it. Her last name was the same name as the woman, Barbara Howard, who started the Women of 20s campaign. So is that coincidence? Is that divine intervention? Was that the spirits talking? You know, what is this?
Now, let's go to... Julie, are you there?
Oh, no, maybe. She's not here yet.
Okay. All right. Anybody else that needs to ask Corey a question before we go to commercial break? Okay.
No.
Well, let's go to commercial break. Corey, hang in there for a bit. Let's go to commercial break. And I want you to, when we come back, TJ, I want you to break it down. Let's make it happen.
Are you looking to dress to impress? Then Lansing's House of Style is the place. 1122 West Holmes Road, Suite 7, Lansing, Michigan, 48910, located in the Logan Square Plaza at the corner of West Holmes Road and South MLK. Ask for Shotgun. Tell them you heard it on CRS Radio and receive a 10% discount. We'll be right back right after this.
From author Dr. Denise Gotatis comes a self-help guide that will give you valuable information about the world around you in ways never imagined. The Metaphysical God in Relation to His Creation, available on Amazon. In this must-read book, you will learn about your importance in the world and the metaphysical universe around you. You will be introduced to the Metaphysical God who has a relationship with you and those around you. Whether you are aware of this or not, you come into contact with Him daily. He is omnipresent metaphysically. He is in and outside of His creation. And what does a metaphysical God have to do with you and the creation around you? You are a very big piece of a huge puzzle. The Metaphysical God in Relation to His Creator, from author Dr. Denise Gotatis, is available on Amazon. Order your copy right now.
God bless. God bless.
God bless the dark skin baby birthed in America. We're against all odds, broken and can't repair the trust. We'll love to tell my kids that we're all created equal. And you can be whatever you want, but that wouldn't be true. But as people are cruel, hateful, and judge you, before they know what you're about, they see you as in trouble. Failure is imminent, the system holds no sentiment. Stay away from crime, you're guilty when even innocent. Police don't protect and serve, they harass and kill. Driving while black can turn you into another Castile. Walking from the store can get you shot with your hands on my mother's fear. A baby you killed or put in handcuffs. You're black for a reason, embrace it, never reject it. Work twice as hard, they won't like it, but they'll respect it. Everyone isn't the same, just choose your friends wisely. No compromising your color just to inherit nice things. Watch your own kind, they can be just as evil. Once they see you come up, down, they will try to keep you. Keep your faith in God, cause prayer is your greatest weapon. The devil is very real, and you'll need His protection. God bless. God bless. God bless. God bless, please watch over my soul. Grab the wheel, I feel you're in total control. God bless, protect us out here in these streets. We're against all odds, the evil is deep. God bless, the child that can hold their own. Those who can, make sure they grab hold of the song. God bless, cheer, God bless, God bless. God bless, please watch over my soul. Grab the wheel, I feel you're in total control. God bless, protect us out here in these streets. We're against all odds, the evil is deep. God bless, the child that can hold their own. Those who can, make sure they grab hold of the song. God bless, cheer, God bless.
Let me talk to you,
God bless the white baby born in this world, protected, given everything it needs so it'll never be affected by poverty. Working two dead end, jobs to feed four and father kids whose road to success all the streets. You'll be considered white trash if you aren't rich enough. Lazy redneck who loves being hunting and pickup trucks, living in the trailer parks. Mother on prescription pills, father beat you when he's drunk. Your eyes roll while you eat your meal. School is a different monster, bullied by the prominent. Middle class living is still considered a pile of shit. Groundhog Day with the taunt and the hate. Too young to deal with the turmoil. You just want to escape. No one wants to listen. They tell you you'll be fine, but they don't know what's in your heart, what's really on your mind. Now you're feeling the world's better without you, without you. The voices in your head are at an increased value. Now you're all alone, rethinking the events, crying your soul dry, feeling this is it. Maybe if you died, then everyone would quit. Suicide by a child is nothing worse than it. God bless. God bless. God bless. God bless. God bless, please watch over my soul. Grab the wheel, I feel you're in total control. God bless, protect us out here in these streets. We're against all odds, the evil is deep. God bless, the child that can hold their own. Those who can, make sure they grab hold of the song. God bless, cheer, God bless, God bless. God bless, please watch over my soul. Grab the wheel, I feel you're in total control. God bless, protect us out here in these streets. We're against all odds, the evil is deep. God bless, the child that can hold their own. Those who can, make sure they grab hold of the song. God bless, cheer, God bless.
We have to be careful how we nurture our youth. That gravitational pull has to become a push instead, as we model effective behaviors to program boys who come in. We have to push children in the right direction. Human nature will always have a strong force of attraction, but we have to be deliberate and intentional in displaying the true success in the way we provide real footprint of a man as primary attraction for our boys.
God bless. Please watch over my soul. watch over my soul. Grab the wheel, I feel you in total control. God bless, protect us out here in these streets. We're against all odds, the evil is deep. God bless, the child that can hold their own. Those who can, make sure they grab hold of the song. God bless, yeah, God bless.
White folks are fighting to keep what they got to get even more, and black folks are fighting to survive. And America don't give a fuck whether we make it or not.
Yeah, obviously, your people got a raw deal. I'm not saying that. What I'm saying is that just because the playing field isn't level, it doesn't mean you don't have every opportunity.
You really believe that?
Yes, I do. That's what makes America great.
See, what you don't realize, Reed, is there's two Americas, and we don't live in the same one. But you know what's interesting about that? That despite that, somehow, the two of us still ended up doing dirt. I mean, I know why I'm doing it. What I don't understand is why you.
Introducing Caribbean Radio Show, the chat reel with Billy and friends. And now, here is your host, Billy Tappan.
Hey, and we're back. We are CRS with Billy and friends at the chat reel, and we are the Knowledge Station. And as we are coming back, we're coming back with Corey Mcleichy, and what a great time we've had, and what a great story. We're at the end of the road now, and if you didn't catch it, you can also get it on a rerun, and you can actually listen in. So we're going back to Corey real quick before we actually get out of here. Corey, any last words?
Oh, yeah, man. Just want to thank you, you and your staff again for having me, man. Shout out to all the ethnicities throughout the world. It's all about peace, love, and prosperity, positivity, everything of that nature. I want to just recap the songs. Appreciate you playing the songs. My bro, Tai Chi. Tykeus is what he go by, Tykeus. Tykeus, you could check him out, tykeus.net. I built a website, I also host that website as well. You can download his songs off of that platform, as well as stream all of his music on all music platforms, Apple, Spotify, Google Play, Tidal, what have you. The song you heard today in order was I Just Want to Live, Bigger Man, Disbelieve, The Disconnect, and God Bless. And if you notice, all those songs were positive. You know, trying to give our youth some insight on how to survive out here instead of, harming each other or getting caught up with the law or just getting into some wrongdoings. We're trying to give you that insight on how to move around in a wicked world that we live in. So, you know, I like I said, once again, thanks to the radio station for having me. Good looking cuz, big cuz, Billy Tappan and friends. It was a pleasure, and I hope we can do this again soon.
Oh, well, we definitely will, Corey, definitely. And we appreciate having you on. And I know our listeners, we got a caller coming in, so don't leave. So let's see what he's got to say. Caller, if you will.
Hello, can you hear me?
Yes.
Go ahead. Okay.
Hi. The speaker was just talking and mentioned the link so that we can listen to the rerun. Where can we access that link at?
It should be downloaded by tomorrow at least, and you can listen to the beginning to the end.
Okay.
So if
thank you.
But you can ask Ty questions. Corey questions if you'd like.
Oh,
you know.
And by the way, caller, after the program airs, you can actually go to thecaribbeanradioshow.com and you can look for CRS Radio, the chat reel with
okay.
Billy and friends, you know, with this guest that we have today. You could listen to any of the shows that you would like to listen to on the Caribbean Radio Show.
So they're all on demand on the link you just said?
Yes.
Yes.
CRSradio.com.
Oh, yes.
Right, thank you
can
so
listen
much.
Anytime you'd like. Okay. Thanks for asking the question.
All right.
Thank you,
thank you so much, caller. All right. Let's do this. Corey, we're going to play. We're going to go to a commercial break, and then we're going to come back, and we'll be ready to tag out. So hang out for a minute, and we'll do the countdown and see where we're at, and we'll be right back.
All right. You're listening to CRS Radio, the chat reel with Billy and Friends on the Knowledge Station. We'll be right back with our guest this week, Corey Mcleichy. Stay tuned.
Hello, and shalom, chat viewers. This is Dr. Denise Sotadis, metaphysician, philosopher, and psychotherapist. I'm one of the hosts of the chat reel with Billy and Friends. I'm also the host of the Black Jewish Queen Life Chat. I'm here to announce another good friend of Billy Sapp and his friends, the writer of The Matrix and The Terminator, the original Oracle herself, Oscar award-winning sci-fi writer, Sophia Stewart. Did you know that Sophia Stewart has a lineup of fantastic books available, especially for those who love and enjoy her written work and movies of The Matrix and The Terminator? If you love these movies, you will love her books. Her latest book is quite exciting for those who love The Matrix. It is called The Evolution of Conscience, Matrix 4. That's right, The Evolution of Conscience, Matrix 4. This is a must-read for those who love The Matrix. I am happy to announce that this book is now available at your local Barnes & Noble Best Bookseller. And it is also a recommended book at Goodreads, along with your other best-selling five-star books, The Third Eye, The Mother of The Matrix, and The Matrix Trivia. All of these books were written by Sophia Stewart. These books are popular, and they are selling fast. So I advise you to go and order your copy today. Don't forget, they are available at Barnes & Noble, Amazon, and Goodreads. You could also visit her webpage at thetruthaboutmatrix.com. That is thetruthaboutmatrix.com. Order yours before supplies run out.
Introducing Caribbean Radio Show, the chat reel with Billy and Friends. And now, here is your host, Billy Tappin.
All right, and we're back. It's Billy Tappin with CRS Radio, the Knowledge Station with Billy and Friends on the chat reel. We are worldwide. We are climbing in numbers, and we are that deal. So we have several stations. Tomorrow we have myself, Billy and Billy, that's going to be at 8 o'clock tomorrow, and we have Tim Cunningham at 6 o'clock tomorrow. That will be jazz chat with Tim
Eastern time.
And with Motown alumni Billy Wilson and myself, Billy Tappin, we'll be on at 8 o'clock, and Tim on at 8, at 6 rather. You're going to love the show, so please tune in. Any last words from anybody before we get out of here? Corey, anything?
Like I was saying, peace and love to the masses and the multitude. You know, I give my salams to all my brothers out there that's deaning and fasting during the month of Ramadan. Salam alaikum to all the brothers and sisters out there. And, you know, like I say, thank you to your radio station once again for just having me on the show and letting me speak my piece and try to share what I got coming, up in the next year or so. You know, just sharing that exclusive information with you. Like I said, you're my family, so I told you I was going to let it be known on your station first. We didn't get a chance to get into the hologram that I'm actually working on, the Sojourner Truth hologram, where I would go to the classrooms and share that with the youth to tell her story. It's going to be real exclusive, you know, along with my Top Notch Kids campaign to try to prevent the violence that's going on in the streets. Now, you know, it went from stop the violence to prevention. So that's what the kids program is all about, Top Notch Kids. We're trying to prevent them from having to get in a situation where it's already too late. You know, me and my brother started to stop the violence movement in 1988. Me, him, and some friends, Sharon Martin and Macaroni, rest in peace, Macaroni Davis.
Macaroni.
And,
oh, my gosh.
Yeah, man. Yep.
Take me back, man.
Yeah. You back. Yep. So he was a big part of, you know, Macaroni was a big part of the movement, man. And so it went from Stop the Violence to, you know, it formed into the Top Notch Kids program because it's turned into prevention. We don't want none of these kids going to prison. We tired of losing loved ones, people getting shot. You know, we got some gruesome murders that happen in our family. And, you know, yeah, we can go and retaliate and kill up the whole household, but why? For what? We trying to prevent that, man. Everybody tired of losing the people they love, you know, and it's starting to get numb to some people. And that's what I'm all about. And although I don't get a lot of support, you know, I take pictures of my bank statements from my nonprofit just to show people talking all this shit in the city and wherever else in the Grand Rapids, they talking about doing something, but they ain't even supporting somebody that's trying to do something. So what you talking about?
Well,
you just
always
talking.
Been like that. It's always been like that in Grand Rapids.
But I don't need nobody's support because, you know, I use my own money to give to the kids that work with me and to give back to the community. I don't need no praise, no recognition, because I do it all for the pleasure of God. You know, so that's where I get my blessings from. So
that's
what it is.
That's why we're here. That's why we're here, because we're here because of that. And like I said, we're going to change this one step at a time, and that's what I do. So until next time, my friend and my cousin, we will have you back. Once you get everything ready to go, all we have to do is touch bases, and it's a done deal.
Let me tell them, too. Be on the lookout for your website. Give them the name of your website that I'm working on.
It's going to be Gabriel Entertainment. What's happening.
Be on the lookout for that, everybody, because it's going to be fire. I'm building it, and I'm letting all your listeners know right now it's going to be incredible. It's going to be fire.
It's going to be fire for real, and I cannot wait. I've seen part one of it, and I'm telling you, it's going to be on point. So until next time, we will have you back on. When things start coming together a little bit more, we'll bring you back. But we had an enjoyable time, and let's give Corey a nice peace out.
Hey, Billy, before we go, can we get Corey to announce his platforms again where people can get a hold of him? One more time.
Yes. Carlos, go ahead and announce him.
Okay, yeah. You can reach me at www.descendantsofthetruth.com. I'm also on Instagram at my Instagram is Descendants. What is it? I'm sorry, man. It's not Mcleichy.
That's okay.
It's not Mcleichy, the same name, N-O-K A M I C H I 777 on Instagram. I think I had Twitter, but they kicked me off for some reason. But you can reach me or just Google me. Google my name, Google Corey Mcleichy or Google Nakamichi, and I got like 10 pages of information on Google alone, so you should reach me there somehow, some kind of way. Because right now, I ain't even got all my links together because I'm slipping on
that. That's fine.
But I'm out there
somewhere.
All right.
Yeah. Hey, do this,
that's
man, right. Before we leave up out of here. Give us a little short commercial or whatever you want, and we'll get it on. All right?
Oh, yeah. What would you say? Like what?
Whatever you want to talk about. You know? Whatever you're trying to push, we got you.
About
what I'm saying, I'll have TJ.
Okay, in that case, let me just say this: I am the unofficial website builder for kiyus.net. That's TYCHIUS.net. Check him out. His music banging, got some good content there, and you could learn a lot more about him. I also built DreBanks.world. Website, check him out. That's Dre Banks, D-R-E Banks, BANKS.world website. I'm also working on my mother-in-law website, BunnyTheBars.world. That's coming soon. Be on the lookout for that. Put that in your phones. Lock it in. That's BunnyTheBars.world. Coming real soon. I'm working on her site. And I'm also working on my cousin's site, Billy Tappin.
And you let them know the name of that again, cuz.
Oh, man, it's going to be Gabriel Entertainment in conjunction with CRS Radio. So we're
That's
all
right.
good. And
yes,
you
sir,
tell buddy,
I'm building that and integrating it into your CR. I'm building it to integrate it. That's the plan, too, to integrate your website into the CRS, CR, CSR radio station. To, you know, it's all family. That's what it is. That's what we're doing.
That's
all positivity. You know what I'm saying? It's all inclusive, for real. You know, just because black people's plight is much worse than the rest of the world, we still inclusive to the world, period. You know what I'm saying? So
right.
don't try to kill us and don't try to neglect us and dog us and then jack our style, you know what I'm saying, and be culture vultures to how we do. You know what I'm saying? Come on. You can't do that. We ain't going to let you.
Right.
So hey, either roll with us or get rolled over. You know, that's how we doing.
Corey.
We, you know?
Hey, Cab yes, Bunny, call me. I got a show for her. I got a gospel show for her. It's waiting
hey,
on her.
Already put her up on it. You know, we talk, me and her, we talk on a every other day type of basis, you know, so I'll let her know. But I already told her about the show. She ready to come on, you know. So you just got to get
okay.
her on the schedule. She going to do it because, you know, she know I keep my word and I do what I say I'm going to do.
Okay,
so,
I want to give her a show. I want to give her a gospel show. You know
oh,
what I'm
she
saying?
Might keep up on that. Because, you know, Bunny,
yeah,
what the world don't know, they never seen the comical side of Bunny. She, man, she'll have you loving God and laughing and crying at the same time.
We need that. So hook it up and we'll
she
talk.
She is a funny good woman, son. Yeah, I'll let her know, man.
Okay.
I'll let her
All right,
know.
Talk to you in a bit. All right. All right. We're out of here, PJ. Take us out, my brother.
You've been listening to CRS Radio, the Knowledge Station, Billy and Friends on the chat reel. It's April 3rd, 2020, and we are out. Thank you very much for listening. See us again next Monday at 8 p.m. chat reel with Billy and Friends on CSR Radio, the Knowledge Station.